later, okay?
But it's really important.
What is it?
A letter from Mary.
Huh?
I want to go get it. Is that okay?
Yes, yes.
Come on, hurry up.
Is it in there?
In the back.
What are you doing, Laura?
It's further back in the desk.
Laura! What are you doing?
You.
Open the door, Laura.
Why should I? I'm a liar, right? Want me to open it? Huh? Huh? Do ya? What's the magic word?
Laura?
Okay, I guess it won't open it. I think I'll just leave you like this.
You snotty little brat! Open up!
You...
Laura?
You hurt me!
Thank you. okay? Angela, relax.
Don't order me around!
I'm not trying to order you.
So what do you want then? Oh, I see. You're trying to be nice to me, right? I know what you're up to. It's always the same. You're only after one thing.
No, that's not true at all.
You don't have to lie. Go ahead and say it. Or you could just force me. Beat me up like he always did. You only care about yourself anyway. You disgusting pig.
Angela.
Don't touch me. You make me sick. You said your wife Mary was dead, right?
Yes, she was ill.
Liar! I know about you. You didn't want her around anymore. You probably found someone else.
That's ridiculous. I never... Eddie, what are you doing?
What does it look like? He always busted my balls. You fat, disgusting piece of shit. You make me sick. Fat ass, you're nothing but a waste of skin. You're so ugly, even your mama don't love you. Well, maybe he was right. Maybe I am nothing but a fat, disgusting piece of shit. But you know what? It doesn't matter if you're smart, dumb, ugly, pretty. It's all the same once you're dead.
And a corpse can't laugh.
From now on, if anyone makes fun of me, I'll kill him. Just like that.
Have you gone nuts?
I knew it.
You too. You're just like him, James.
Hey, I didn't mean anything.
Don't bother. I understand. You've been laughing at me all along, haven't you? Ever since we first met. I'll kill you, James.
Do you know what it does to you, James? When you're hated, pissed.
spit on just because of the way you look after you've been laughed at your whole friggin' life. That's why I ran away after I killed the dog. Ran away like a scared little girl. Yeah, I killed that dog. It was fun. It tried to chew its own guts up. Finally died all curled up in a ball. Then he came after me. I shot him too, right in the leg. He cried more than the dog. He's gonna have a hard time playing football on what's left of that knee.
You think it's okay to kill people? You need help, Eddie.
Don't get all holy on me, James. This town called you too. You and me are the same. We're not like other people. Don't you know that? Let's party!
Thank you. Eddie? Eddie?
I killed a human being. A human being. Mary. Did you really die 3 years ago? I was weak. That's why I needed you. Needed someone to punish me for my sins. But that's all over now. I know the truth. Now it's time to end this. Thank you. Mary?
Wrong again.
Mary's dead. You killed her.
Maria? Maria, I'm done with you.
What do you mean? But I can be yours. I'll be here for you forever. And I'll never yell at you or make you feel bad. That's what you wanted.
Now I understand. The problem is, you're not married.
No, James. I won't let you. I'll never let you have your Mary back.
Thank you.
James. James.
Mary?
James.
Forgive me.
I told you that I wanted to die, James. I wanted the pain to end.
That's why I did it, honey. I just couldn't watch you suffer. No. That's not the whole truth. You also said that you didn't want to die. The truth is, part of me hated you for taking away my life.
You killed me, and you're suffering for it. It's enough, James.
Mary?
James!
Now I understand the real reason I came to this town. I wonder, what was I afraid of? Without you, Mary, I've got nothing. Now we can be together.
In my restless dreams, I see that town. Silent Hill. You promised you'd take me there again someday, but you never did. Well, I'm alone there now, in our special place, waiting for you. Waiting for you to come to see me. But you never do. And so I wait, wrapped in my cocoon of pain and loneliness. I know I've done a terrible thing to you. Something you'll never forgive me for. I wish I could change that. But I can't. I feel so pathetic and ugly laying here, waiting for you. Every day I stare up at the cracks in the ceiling, and all I can think about is how unfair it all is. The doctor came today. He told me I could go home for a short stay. It's not that I'm getting better. It's just that this may be my last chance. I think you know what I mean. Even so, I'm glad to be coming home. I've missed you terribly. But I'm afraid, James. I'm afraid you don't really want me to come home. Whenever you come see me, I can tell how hard it is on you. I don't know if you hate me or pity me. Or maybe I just disgust you. I'm sorry about that. When I first learned that I was going to die, I just didn't want to accept it. I was so angry all the time, and I struck out at everyone I loved most. Especially you, James. That's why I understand if you do hate me. But I want you to know this, James. I'll always love you. Even though our life together had to end like this, I still wouldn't trade it for the world. We had some wonderful years together. Well, this letter's gone on too long, so I'll say goodbye. I told the nurse to give this to you after I'm gone. That means that as you read this, I'm already dead. I can't tell you to remember me. But I can't bear for you to forget me. These last few years since I became ill, I am so sorry for what I did to you, did to us. You've given me so much, and I haven't been able to return a single thing. That's why I want you to live for yourself now. Do what's best for you, James. James, you made me happy.
Ooh!